On our farm, we have 5 robots and 4 different groups. So our robot one, which we also call group one, is our we call it the heifer robot. So 2-year-olds go through there. And that's kind of the robot the guys work mostly in. You know, a fresh heifer is obviously the one you gotta, you know, train in a robot and make sure they're okay in there. So that one is all heifers. We didn't want to have any boss cows in with them. We wanted to make sure they were with their peers. And that's the robot my guys work the most with to train those heifers. Then we have our robot two is our group two, and that's our compost pack. And so all of our fresh cows would go to the pack just so they get on their feet, lots of space. We run less cows on that robot, so we're running around 40, 45 cows on that robot. Lots of time, lots of availability for robot time. And we wanna get as many milkings out of them as we can. And then our robot three, which is our group three, it's a single robot. And that's all of our higher days in milk cows, you know, the quicker milkers. So we've run up to 78 cows on that one robot without too much trouble. And that's a pretty good producing robot for us. The cows, we have 0 fetch cows in those robots. You know, it's pretty smooth operating. And then in our group four, it's 2 robots. And that's kind of our higher production cows. And that's 2 robots for that group. So that's kind of how the robots have gone. We had that in mind when we started. We didn't quite know which cows would go where, but that's kind of what it's evolved into.